Thanks. South Carolina playing a crucial role in getting help to Haiti. Airmen from Charleston Air Force Base are flying missions all around the clock.
News 4's Mandy Gaither is the only local reporter to fly with them to the earthquake-ravaged country. Here's an exclusive firsthand account of the aftermath.
We landed in Haiti at night, and in doing so, we saved ourselves a lot of time. There's only one runway and a lot of planes filled with humanitarian aid trying to land during the day. Crews only have 2 hours to land, offload, and take off again to make room for others bringing aid from around the world.
Before the sun went down, inspiration for this mission of mercy stared up at crews carrying precious cargo to a country in desperate need of it. This is the devastation seen from the cockpit of a Charleston Air Force Base C-17. Homes and buildings reduced to rubble, a tragic sight touching even the strongest of military men and women.
Pretty emotional. You see all those people in distress. Some folks are standing on their roofs and they have nowhere else to go.
From day to nighttime on the ground in Haiti, everywhere we looked, crews from all over the world worked on little sleep. Some hadn't slept in 3 days. A few steps off the airstrip, two Haitian survivors pulled from the rubble were seen resting underneath these blankets. All who were hurt and cared for by the U.S. military come through this small, cramped medical tent.
We've seen up to about 40, 50 patients, and a lot of them are crush injuries, fractures, lacerations. We've had one patient, local Haitian, that survived for 80 hours that we stabilized and got out of here.
Meanwhile, it took only 45 minutes for airmen to unload the more than 72,000 pounds of humanitarian aid from the plane we flew in on. This load, picked up at Homestead Base in Miami, included hygiene kits, MREs, and nearly 40,000 bottles of water, all now ready to help Haiti.
The biggest problem now, getting all of this stuff to the people who need it most, because many of the roads here have been destroyed. Airmen plan to drop this aid from the air to get it to the victims more quickly. Mandy Gaither, WYFF News 4 in Haiti.